innovation, excellence, compassion. This is St. Joe's.
Today, I'm Barb Moyer. You ever put off surgery? Your doctor said you need it, you know you need to have it, but you don't like the pain after surgery. Or maybe your body reacts to narcotics and you don't like that either. There may be another option for you, perhaps. We're going to be talking tonight about a revolutionary pain management system called OnCue, but rather than have me talk about it, we have three guests with us tonight that are very uniquely qualified to talk about it from three different perspectives. So let me introduce them. To my left is Alan Miller. Alan is a CRNA, and we'll talk about what that is in a minute. To her left is Sue Hodgkins. Sue is an RN at St. Joe's, has been with us for about 20 years, and has been working in the recovery room, and is now our pain management nurse. To her left is Barb Swavely of Muhlenberg, and Barb had a total knee replacement in January using the OnCue system, and several years ago she had extensive knee surgery without the OnCue system, so she can talk about the differences. All right, let's jump right in. Alan, talk about what is a CRNA, first of all.
A CRNA is a certified registered nurse anesthetist, and we administer anesthesia. I'm a registered nurse, and I attended graduate school and have a master's degree in nursing, and I trained for 27 months to administer anesthesia. We work at St. Joe's with anesthesiologists as a team to take care of our patients.
And this may sound very silly because it should be obvious, but what's the goal of anesthesia?
Well, the goal, first and foremost, is always patient comfort. We're always worried, are our patients comfortable? Are they what we call amnestic, meaning are they remembering what's going on or are they forgetting? Obviously, we want everybody to forget. And also, finally, we need to help our surgeons out, and we need to make sure that they can get proper visualization, and we need to make sure the patients are still for them while they operate.
Okay. And how do you make that happen? What are your options?
There's several different options, and many of them depend on what kind of procedure you're having done, where are you having it done, are you going to go home that day, things like that. First and foremost, there's always general anesthesia, which is what most people have heard of, where you count back from 100, take a deep breath, and you're off to la-la land, and we breathe for you and monitor you very closely during the procedure. Then there are things like regional anesthesia, which are spinals, epidurals that people hear about for women having babies, and also our new technique, the OnCue system, where we block a particular nerve that feeds just one particular area of the body. And lastly, you can have sedation, which some people have when they get their wisdom teeth out or things like that. It helps you relax while they do a procedure that they can numb just maybe that little area.
Now, how long have we been doing the OnCue system?
We've been doing the OnCue system a little over a year at St. Joe's. Prior to that, what we did was we would place a needle in, inject medication that would numb the area, and then take the needle out. But now with the OnCue system, what we do is we place a tiny, tiny catheter about the size of a hair right alongside the nerve, and it continuously bathes that nerve in numbing medicine. So that area, in this case the knee or the shoulder, would stay numb for several days.
I understand you brought one with you.
I did. All our patients received this special ball, and it's filled with numbing medicine, and then it's hooked up to that tiny catheter, and then each of these balls comes with a little fanny pack, and the patient can attach it to their waist or around their shoulder because they need to take it with them when they move about and do their daily activities.
So what's the difference between, from a patient perspective, or from your perspective, about using OnCue versus the older system?
It's just amazing. I mean, patients wake up, they're pain-free, they haven't required any narcotics, which makes you tired, nauseated, they can make you itchy, very uncomfortable, and these patients are wide awake because they haven't had all the extra sedation and narcotics that are required for surgery. They're pain-free, they're comfortable, they're ready to eat, they're ready to sit up and talk to everybody. They feel great.
So prior to using this, a patient would come in they're having surgery at 10 o'clock. What would happen before 10 o'clock?
Prior to have the on-Q system, mm-hmm. they would get a general anesthetic. So they would go back to the operating room, count back from 100, mm-hmm. and then we would put them to sleep. We would give them IV medication for their pain, but it had many side effects. Now with the on-Q system, we have them come in, we take them to a special holding area where we hook them up to monitors, we give them relaxing medicine while we place this catheter. It's not really painful, but it's often patients are anxious to have their surgery done, and it's a lot to handle. So by giving them just a little bit to take the edge off, a little Valium, medication, they feel much better, more relaxed.
And does that reduce the amount of anesthesia?
It does. Actually, the literature says that you can actually reduce your anesthetic by about 50%. But most importantly, you need your patient to be amnestic, as we say, meaning they don't remember their surgery.
Right.
So also at St. Joe's, we have a special monitor called the BIS monitor. It goes across the forehead. It reads the EEG or the brain waves and the brain activity, and it gives us a number from 0 to 100. Anything below 60, they say, patients will not remember anything. So we're able to give them a lot less anesthesia and guarantee that they won't remember.
Terrific. Okay, Sue, let's switch. The patient has now come out of surgery. They've come over to your old area.
Mm-hmm.
What are you seeing? Well, you've been in recovery for a long time now.
Yeah.
So before on cue, how are patients coming out of, let's say, orthopedic surgeries?
Once they start to wake up, a lot of them are screaming because they're having so much pain. It depends. I mean, everybody's different, but some people are having a lot of pain. And generally in the recovery room, we have to give them a lot of pain medicine to get the pain relieved. Actually, when I first came to the recovery room, I never knew there was that much pain medicine in the whole world. We sometimes give to patients in the recovery room, but we give them a lot of pain medicine until we get them comfortable and they're able to get to their room.
Mm-hmm.
Oftentimes, we set up what's called a PCA, which is a machine that gives them constant pain medicine. We're still doing that, but what we're finding with the on-Q is they're not needing it. But they get the PCA so that they can continually give themselves pain medicine when they go to their room. So there's a lot of pain medicine involved.
Are they waking up any faster?
Many of them come into the recovery room wide awake, sitting up and talking to us. They're not having any pain. They don't need to stay there very long because
mm-hmm.
they don't need the pain medicine that they used to need. So they're pretty much getting to their rooms quicker, getting to be with their families quicker, getting their lunch quicker, you know, all of those things.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Now, from a nursing perspective, because you've been in various units in the hospital and have taken mm-hmm. care of orthopedic patients post-op mm-hmm. in the rooms or in the units, what is the difference once they get back to the room from a nursing perspective?
It's night and day. I've never seen anything like this. It's and I, as the pain management nurse, I've been following them now,
mm-hmm.
and these patients are able to get up sooner, they're able to walk sooner, they're able to eat sooner, they can visit with their families, they're not all groggy, they're not throwing up, they're breathing better, they're not having all of those issues that the narcotics would give them, you know, in the past. It's
mm-hmm.
just absolutely amazing. Their recoveries are just going so much better than they have done in the past. It's like a revolutionary treatment. I just can't believe how great it works.
I do want to interrupt. This is a live show for tonight on Wednesday, so if you have questions for any of those sitting here, you are more than welcome to call in. The number will be at the bottom of your screen. Okay, Barb, let's go over to an actual perspective. Now, you were a patient. You were a patient before and had extensive knee surgery, and now you came back to have total knee replacement,
yes,
which
yes.
I understand can be very painful.
Yes.
And you had the on-Q system. What was your experience?
I specifically wanted something because I didn't want to have to take a lot of pain meds.
Mm-hmm.
I had problems with spinals before, and I had asked my doctor about it and said, what is my other option? And that's when we started talking about the femoral block and using the system. And so I was like, great, because I need to be in control of my pain, not a mess. And having it put in, there was no pain involved in that. And coming out of surgery, I have had surgery and been in a lot of pain and know what to expect, and it was wonderful. I came out, was out of the recovery room a lot faster. Getting up to the room when they take you from the gurney onto the bed, that's always a horrible thing because no matter how careful they're being, they're jostling you and something you've just had work on. And that was a breeze, and I was like, wow, this is great. And when you were talking, I happened to remember, I was taking phone calls right after surgery, and people were like going, oh, sorry, and I'm like, oh, no problem, and I was talking. It was easy. So much easier than anything I'd had before.
Now, how long do you think it took for you to feel like yourself?
I felt like myself right away.
Mm-hmm.
And not the grogginess.
Right.
I always had a lot of problems with nausea.
Mm-hmm.
And just being out of it, you know, where you're just one minute you're like conscious and the next minute you can't even talk, you know, you're knocked out. And my family was with me right away. My daughter stayed with me every night in the hospital, and I had that help, and it was much easier. It was much easier.
Now, how about your physical therapy? I understand with orthopedic surgery, you've got to move right away. You can't let that joint.
Well, that was, I did have PCA with a narcotic,
mm-hmm.
and that you only hit the button as needed, and I really didn't need to hit the button unless, like, the first morning they get you up after surgery. It was probably 1 o'clock by the time I got to my room, and they were nice to me and didn't make me get up then. But the next morning they were in there and getting me up, and I did have to pre-med myself a little bit because that was really painful, and trying to get up and go to the bathroom and things like that. That was where the extra stuff. But
mm-hmm.
when I was just laying there and I had exercises to even do in bed, I did not have that pain. I had a lack of feeling a little
mm-hmm.
because of the numbness. The whole leg was kind of numb down to, I guess I could move, I moved my feet and stuff, but as far as I could lift my whole leg. So it was pretty good.
Now, did you go home with that?
No, I didn't. I had my surgery on Wednesday, and Friday afternoon, early evening, they took the pump out off. That wasn't painful either. I like those things. And then the next day, I didn't have that at all. And I did have an increase in pain because, you know, it was a little bit of a change, but yet there was still a lot of that in your system. So,
mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, you're walking, you know, you can move it. It's not like it's just hanging there. You say a nerve block, and I think of, my leg's going to be, you know, just hanging.
Yeah,
wasn't
that.
Like that. Yeah, wasn't like that at all.
Now, there's actually a couple different uses for the pain ball.
There is. Currently, at St. Joe's, we have the nerve blocks. We do spinal nerve blocks for our total knees. We do blocks for our shoulders, arms, and our feet.
Mm-hmm.
But Dr. Beadle also uses them where he places them in the incision site to numb that area as well. And patients go home with those, and he has a very particular regimen where they remove them themselves or come back to his office. And they're also very successful. Patients have much better pain control
mm-hmm.
when they do have those. And there's use for hernias and things like that.
So we're already doing that.
We are doing that. And there's some plastic surgeons and stuff like that use them. But primarily it's Dr. Beadle doing them.
Mm-hmm. Now, how did you get involved with St. Joe's? And you actually came to the hospital to introduce us to the system, I believe?
Well, I moved to Reading with my significant other 2 years ago, and where I had worked previously, this was a standard of care for us. Every patient received a nerve block that was having any kind of orthopedic procedure or procedure on their leg or their arm.
Mm-hmm.
And really, it was one of those things that is just kind of coming to be. And when I came here, I said, look, these patients do so much better. They use less pain meds. And I kind of was able to get the orthopedic surgeons on board, and they slowly come around, but they are really supportive now and really want this for their patients.
You had to, when we talked, the pre-interviews are always fun because I learned so much, but when we talked ahead of time, you said one of the biggest issues is patient education ahead of time.
It
a
is.
Patient comes in for surgery, the last thing they want to hear about at that point is some new fad. It's not a new fad, but to them, it's a new fad approach. So if we can educate them early, they can ask for it.
It is, and a lot of patients are very fearful that they're going to get this and they're still going to be awake, and that's not the case at all.
Good point.
They get this and they still go to sleep. They still get general anesthesia.
Mm-hmm.
You can do some procedures without the general anesthetic, but we're finding that really our patients still want this. And because of that, we still put them to sleep, but patients come in and they're very frightened and
sure.
they don't want to hear about it. But it's really important, and it really does change your recovery. So we really like to try to talk to them about it. And we do have patient information in our pre-admission area for patients if they want to read about it beforehand. So, and one of the things we're doing now also is we're starting to send our patients home with these.
Okay.
Originally, you know, all programs have like an evolution, and it involved first as doing these single shot blocks, and then it involved putting the catheters in, and now we've moved to sending our patients home with them. So people that are having shoulder surgery, they used to spend the night because of their problems with pain. Now they can go home with these, and they get to go home that night, they're wide awake, they get to eat dinner with their family.
So from your perspective, what are you seeing as a pain management nurse now? Jumping out of the recovery room, are you able to encourage people to do this or help them with this?
I would. I certainly would. I don't see the patients pre-op generally. I see them post-op, but anyone that I knew, I would certainly encourage them to get one of these, or anybody that I knew that had surgery, because they just are working so well. That's my perspective. I don't really see them until afterwards, but I know that the doctor's offices are also educating the patients when they're making that decision to have surgery in the doctor's office. A lot of the doctors are encouraging them and teaching them about it then, so that they can make that choice before they even come to the hospital.
Now, before we open up a can of worms here and have everybody calling the doctor saying, I want this for every surgery I've ever had, what are the contraindications? Who couldn't have this, or what type of surgery maybe?
Well, primarily the indications are orthopedic surgery right now, and the big contraindication for us is patient refusal. If patient refuses, we can't do it. Also, patients that have nerve damage or problems with their nerves, some diabetics, things like that, cannot have it. And sometimes blood thinners, it depends on when they stopped it or you know, exactly what's going on with their blood thinners. We don't like to use them. And patients do need to be awake while we put them in, because we need them to tell us if they're having any unusual sensations. So if patients aren't really willing to do that or able to do that, then they're not really good candidates. But for the most part, you know, the vast majority of our patients are candidates for this.
Are you, number-wise, about how many of our surgeries are obviously we're seeing an increase in it. Do you have any idea how many surgeries use this versus how many don't? That may be a tough question.
That's a really tough question. I'm not really sure. You know, we attempt to offer this to every single orthopedic patient at St. Joe's, if they're a good candidate. Pretty much if they're a candidate. I'm not aware. I would actually have to ask the rep as far as numbers and how many we use a week. So I'm sorry, I can't answer that question.
I'd like to see more.
I would like to see more. Everybody gets them. For the obvious reason that they do better, they get out of the hospital faster, they have less complications. They also rehab better. There's a lot of data out there that says that they have better ability to bend their knee after total knee replacement because they can go through rehab without all that pain.
Right.
And there's a lot of passive rehab that happens where they will be there and the therapist is bending their leg for them and able to bend it a lot further because they're not having pain.
Okay, so the range of motion is coming back quicker.
Also, the other nice thing about it is actually patients that do have a lot of other things wrong with them, this is a good thing for them, because sometimes with other disease processes that they may have going on, the narcotics, they're not allowed to be taking that many narcotics.
Okay.
So this is actually good for people who may have breathing problems, who may have heart problems, you know, who may have stomach problems, any of those things. It's really hard to take pain pills. And something like this is actually good for them, because then they don't have to take all that pain medicine. So it's actually working even better for those people who have a lot of things wrong with them, and there's really very few things that they can't have it, the pain ball for, you know, so it's actually even better for those patients.
Barb, when you had your first surgery, it wasn't your first surgery,
but
your other knee surgery.
Yes.
Do you remember how you woke up and how you recovered from that?
It was a very painful, I had a high tibial osteotomy where they basically removed part of the leg bone to realign my knee over to carry the weight on the outside of my knee, because I had no cartilage on the inside. It's a very, very painful. It's right there with having your knee replaced. That's who I rehabbed with. That's who I was in the hospital. St. Joe's again, who I was in with. But it was a lot of pain.
How about your physical therapy afterwards? With the first surgery, I was right there with, you know, with the, all the new knees. I was there, so just kind of know what I was getting into,
right.
And that made me even more scared because I didn't want all this pain, you know.
So you knew to ask for that.
Well, you know, I was thinking that it was their brochure that I got coming into the hospital. The pre-admission testing,
okay.
They give you a really nice, very thorough, and that's where it mentioned the femoral block, and that's when I started asking questions. So it's good.
I understand we have a home viewer. How can we help you? Do we have a caller on the line?
Hello?
Hi, can we help you?
Yes.
What's your question?
Are you there?
Yes.
I would like to know who removes the catheter after it's been in for the 2 days that it's supposed to stay in?
Are you talking about in the hospital or if a patient goes home with it?
At home.
You have two options.
At home.
Okay.
You have two options if you go home with a catheter and you are not comfortable removing it, you can come back in and we will be happy to remove it for you. We also give you very nice instructions if you would like to remove it by yourself at home. It's actually not that difficult to remove. It's a Band-Aid and some tape, and you literally just pull it out. It's not stuck in there. It's just actually sitting right under the skin, and so you would just pull it out. And so far, every patient that we've asked to remove the catheter has removed the catheter without any problems.
Does that answer your question?
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Miller.
Do we have any future plans with OnQ? Anything new coming down the pike that we're planning on doing?
I think really our big project right now is working on our patients that are going home with them. We've just started doing that in the past few weeks, maybe a little over a month now. And, you know, that's always a process improvement for us. One of them was, like the caller asked, about removing the catheters.
Sure.
We redid our instructions to kind of make them a little more user-friendly. So that's our big project right now, as far as just trying to get those patients to go home with them.
Mm-hmm. Now, I understand the pain ball that we're using right now, I believe, is preset at one specific, I don't know the numbers, but one specific number for anesthesia. So everybody gets the same dosage over the hour.
Right.
We're looking at possibly going to a different system or a more user-friendly, where you can add more pain medicine.
Right now, the ball that we purchase at St. Joe's is a standard 5 mLs per hour, 5 cc's per hour.
Mm-hmm.
We found that for, you know, the vast majority of our patients, 98% of patients, that's fine. But some patients who might be a little taller, might be a little younger, metabolize drugs a little faster, sometimes we need a little more oomph for them. And so actually the ball I have here is a ball that we're trialing where we would dial in a higher number for those patients,
mm-hmm.
and we would also be able to bolus the patients with this product. So we're looking at getting that, and right now we're trialing it and seeing how it's working for our patients.
But that's not something they would control.
No, absolutely not. That's something that we would control from the anesthesia department.
And how high could it be above the 5 milliliters? How high could it go? Could
this,
you set it for?
This product goes up to 14 cc's or 14 milliliters per hour. And as far as I know, that's the highest any product goes on the market right now.
So we're running out of time. We're down about 3 minutes. Anything you want to particularly jump in and say here about pain management, the system?
Just that I just think it's wonderful, and I, you know, I just see it as the future of healthcare as far as surgery goes, and I'm hoping that a lot more doctors come on board and they're using them for more of their patients, and they can be used for a lot of different kinds of surgeries and other painful conditions patients might have, and I'm hoping to see more and more of them because they've been so successful.
So if you had surgery, you would opt for this?
Yes.
Barb, how about you?
I definitely would do it again. It really made life a lot easier. It was day and night.
Mm-hmm. So I'm sure your family would say the same thing, having lived with you.
Definitely.
If a doctor or a patient has questions about it, who would they contact?
Well, the first thing patients do when they come to us is they go through our pre-admission testing,
mm-hmm.
and always that's the initial point. If they have any questions, we have a lot of brochures and handouts to give them if they'd like to read them. Also, the day of surgery, If you ask any of us, we'll be happy to spend time and talk to you about it. There's also a lot of information online.
Mm-hmm.
This product is called OnQ. It's by iFlow, iFlow.com, and they have a website with a whole patient side to it where patients will be able to read extensively about their product as well.
Mm-hmm. Right. There were a lot of testimonials from patients and from doctors, and I think there are as many as 30 or 40 studies being done on this and how it's better for infection control, it's better for pain relief, it's better for range of motion, better outcomes for orthopedics in particular.
Absolutely, and the company is really invested in making this product the best product on the market. So they really have a lot of studies going on out there, and they're collecting a lot of information. They also put out a lot of information to the patient.
Okay, I think we are about wrapped up here. Any last words? All right. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching. Good night.